Lamp Driver Printed Circuit Board. This video shows how to assemble and check the printed PCB. This is an uncut video. It will show you the complete process from soldering to successfully testing the board. The video is made with the DIP28 version of the MCP23017 I port expander. I provide as well a version with a subboard type of it. Soldering and testing is basically the same. If you are experienced in soldering PCBs, jump to minute 13 and 20 seconds. There starts the testing procedure. Start to solder from the lowest parts to the highest parts. Always measure the resistance of the resistors with an ohmmeter. Using a resistor with a wrong rating is a common fault which will be hard to find later on. Make sure that you don't miss any soldering spot. Check the soldering spots from the top and re-solder in case needed. Check the MOSFETs before soldering. A remarkable number of BS170 and BS250 are broken even they are brand new. Here a little test tool is used. This test tool is part of the files and descriptions I provide. Use a magnifying glass to check whether all the soldering points are okay and there are no short circuits between the soldering points. Now it's time for the first test. Just do this before you solder the screw terminals to the PCB. They are quite expansive and it's almost impossible to remove them later in case the PCB has a non-repair-able problem. For the test, upload the provided test code to your Arduino and wire the SDA and SCL pins accordingly. Put all jumpers into place. Use address 0 for the address jumpers. If the test jumper is plugged in, the onboard LED A0 should light up and flash if the MCP23017 part of the board is okay. After successful first test, solder the screw terminals onto the board. Connect LEDs to the screw terminals to check. Here I use a small PCB with 3mm LEDs. This PCB is as well part of the files and descriptions I provide on cults3d.com. The test code will light up the LEDs in different modes. In the first test mode circle of the code, the address is indicated via LED attached to port A0 to A2. This helps to check the address jumpers. After changing the address of the board and the Arduino must be restarted. This board is working and gets an OK labeled. Thanks for watching.